Hello again, everybody. We are back. This is your friend Will. This is the Memory Lapse. And we are continuing our run with this 18 land Is It Arclight deck in a competitive event. Just maybe not the most original name that WotC could have come up with. Competitive event. But that's what we're playing. And we're trying to get 2-7 wins. We went 3-1 in the first half of this series. So if we rip off a 4-0 here, maybe we can get it done in like under 20 minutes. All right, so we have what looks to be a keep. We're on the play. We have turn two Electromancer. When I first started learning about, well, not first started learning, but when I was thinking this week about switching over to playing some best of one on this channel, one of the things that came to mind immediately was this deck, and that there seemed to be builds with Electromancer but no Enigma Drake, or Enigma Drake but no Electromancer, and by shaving lands you can kind of do both. Whether or not that's amazing, whether or not that's good, I'm not sure. The Electromancer is a little underpowered maybe in this build. All right, so I think we're just gonna blow these cantrips to find another land. And build up this Drake, and then next turn we're gonna have like a maximized velocity turn with the Drake, or we can just play Crackling Drake next turn. If they flash in to block this, we've more or less, I mean, the only thing it's reducing is Lava Coil, so it's not doing that much for us. So this Enigma Drake can crash in for 5 next turn. Or we can just play Crackling Drake. All right. They don't have their enchantment, so I'm feeling kind of okay. So, I'm gonna attack first, because I think I'm just going to play the Crackling Drake, but I want to give them a chance to flash in a Trickster and show us they don't have Essence Scatter. Alright, so then you know what we're going to do, is if they do have Essence Scatter, then we'll use this Lava Coil. Wizard's Retort. Sure. Let's cut down their clock a little bit. Maybe that was bad. Maybe we need to save this for a djinn. Storm Tamer number 2. All right, we're just racing. We can do the exact same play next turn. Whoa, blink of an eye, that's a new one. Not like, I guess, out of the question, it makes sense in the deck. Oh, that's tough. That's rough for us. Now we're in the business of blocking. I think we want to find 2 more cards instead of bringing this back next turn and trying to find lethal that way. Oh, they're really playing around it. Smart by them. I think blowing that lava coil was a huge mistake, but I think have they left up? It feels like they've left up their Storm Tamer mana to protect it, so that we might not have ever actually had an opportunity. I guess we're gonna discovery here. If we see an Arclight on top, that's amazing for us. Do. Just wanna think if we fire off a shock here. Have we played enough spells? We played Discovery. Only played Discovery and Chart, so we do have to play one more spell, right? Yeah, so we're just gonna fire off the shock then. Right, they protect it. Kind of feels like we have to attack with one of the Drakes. Let's do that. We're gonna get it back. We've got three spells, so we're gonna get it back next turn. This is gonna be really close. It's gonna come down to what interaction they have here. We opt into Lava Coil, that would be amazing. So now, if we swing out, they're forced to block with the djinns. Unless they have a bounce spell, but. I probably should have left the Electromancer back in case they have Trickster, actually. It's so hard to beat these double curiosities where they just get to keep drawing into their tricks. So unfair. I feel like one curiosity we could beat, two we don't get to beat. All right, we lost. That's really close. This matchup always feels super tight because they are not trying to interact with you. You're not really trying to interact with them. But that one blink of an eye really saved them. All right, we can't give another loss, so we have to rip off the 4-0 from here. Trickster just gets us every time. Why am I so dumb? Like, why don't I think about that card? It would not have mattered there because they just get to Trickster like the best target no matter what. So the extra swing didn't matter. All right, yeah, we'll keep this. We got blown out by. The dive down wasn't very good. Ooh, okay. Right, so we're gonna go for. Looks like we're probably just gonna go for Drake next turn. Wow. Well, we might not be able to beat this draw if this is their draw. Wow. Are we just gonna go 3-3? That sucks. But this is like such a nut draw. Like any Steamkin draw is probably gonna be hard for us to beat. But Steamkin plus removal. It's a little much. We're not gonna win by losing our Drake. Oh, if they just like unload burn onto it here. Yeah. Oh my god. We were not destined to win this one. What a draw. Turn four, empty hand. They've killed both of our creatures. They have four creatures on board. This card is nutty. Yeah, there's not really even anything we can draw here that's gonna help us. Their draw is actually just like the best possible draw their deck could produce. And we're just dead this turn. Oh, it's gonna be 3-3. At least it was quick. And I think we'll have to consider like how do we change this deck? So let's lose this one real quick. We'll let our opponent win here. If they drew any red spell, 3, 6, 8. Now they don't even need a red spell. But like they even drew another one. I just get to smash us. So the card that's been really bad has been Crackling Drake, honestly. It's felt like I can never cast it. Or it's felt like I haven't had time. So let's claim our prizes. We came 100 gold shy. Oh, we didn't even get a rare. Wow, what a blowout. This is how the other half lives, I guess. Let's take a look at the deck and see what kind of changes we might want to make. This deck viewer is the worst. It feels like we're not maximizing Goblin Electromancer. So I wonder if we can even go like minus two Crackling Drakes plus two discoveries minus a Beacon Bolt and add another like cheap cantrip. Maybe we just go to like 3-3, Discovery and Tormenting Voice, and add one each of the cantrips. I think we just want more cheap stuff so that we can dig and just all these ones and twos, all these twos work with the Electromancer really nicely. Don't know, maybe we want the other jumpstart card. Maybe we want Radical Idea in this deck. This card is always super good with the Goblin Electromancer. Maybe it's just worse than the Crash Through and the Warlord's Fury in this type of build with the Enigma Drake. Done. So that's something that we can try in the future, coming back to this deck. But yeah, that's it for this one. Unfortunate that we started 3-1 into the 0-2. I know that's made for a short video here. Disappointing result, but a fun experiment. And now I think what's next is to figure out what other decks we're going to try to adapt. For me, the next obvious target is something like black green, or like the black green white variants or the green white decks. I definitely want to see what room there is to play with those. And those decks also just seem super robust for best of one. Like, I feel like they have game against red, they have game against obsession. So obsession's definitely one that we could look to try to adapt as well. So lots of room to experiment. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed. Please, leave a comment, hit the subscribe button if you feel like supporting the channel, and stay tuned for another video soonish. Later.